And then there's the wah. There was a time on earth when in the book of heaven an old account was standing for sins yet unforgiven. My name was at the top and many things below. I went to the keeper. I settled it long ago. Long ago. Sing with us. Long ago. Yes, the old account was settled long ago. And that record's clear today. For it washed my sins away. When the old account was settled long ago. The count was large, growing every day. I was always sinning, and I never tried to pray. But when I looked ahead, I saw such pain and woe. I went to my keeper. I settled it long ago, long ago, long ago. Yes, the old account was settled long ago. And that record's clear today, for he washed my sins away when the old account was settled long ago. When in that happy home, my Savior's home above, I'll sing redemption's story. I'll praise him for his love, and I'll not forget that book with pages white as snow. Because I came and settled, I settled it long ago, long ago, long ago. When the old account was settled long ago, and that record's clear today, for he washed my sins away. When the old account was settled long ago. Here's a message. Oh, sinner, trust the Lord. Be cleansed of all your sin. For thus he hath provided for you to enter in. And if you should live 100 years below, up there you'll not regret. You settled it long ago, long ago, long ago. Yes, the old account was settled long ago. And that record's clear today, for he washed my sins away when the old account was settled long ago. And that record's clear today, for he washed my sins away when the old account was settled long ago.
Chris is going to sing a song now. Aaron, where's Aaron Bowles? Is he going to sing tonight?
No, he said he wasn't ready tonight.
Okay, that's all right. So Rachel and Carly, you guys get your song ready. We've got one or two here, and I'm going to break you up, okay? And listen here as will the circle be unbroken.
Circle be unbroken.
They will almost
get your train, put your trust alone in Jesus. Never falter, never fail. Keep your hand on that throttle and your eye on that rail. Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blissful shore where the angels wait to join us in our praise forevermore. One more time, Jerry.
They're up too high, I think, that's how they're going. I'll have to pull it over for a minute and see if we can get sound. Because there's nothing. It was working earlier today, so I don't know what it would be. I got it.
Mom and dad and a school and brother. Lift up your face. Oh, wanderer, come home.
Come sit at the table, come on, taste the grace. There's less for the weary, rest that endures. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can cure.
When I got saved, that one?
Yeah. You've done good, sister. You can do that all the time as far as I'm concerned. But I got saved. We're going to try this new song that Jerry wrote. Let me tell a little story, Jerry. I told you at Sunday school this morning. You know, it's praise night. It was interesting to me. People interest me. And I said this morning, everything you know in life, I don't care what it is, good or bad, you learn from somebody. Again, young people, that's why you put your life in and around good people. Because you get around bad folks, you're going to learn bad things. And so the story is that George Jones, who I think probably, in my mind, the greatest country music singer that ever lived, he lived to be 80. I think he was 80, 81. He was amazed that he lived that long because of the life that he lived. He was an alcoholic and a drug addict for many years. Missed performances. He said himself one time, he said, it's amazing that the Lord let me have the career that I had as hard as I tried to ruin it. But I was telling the class this morning, Vesta Goodman, the singer that had the Goodman family, something about her, her countenance. He saw her one time sing, and it just touched him. And he had a bad car wreck, got killed. And he got so depressed trying to come out of that. And he asked for her to come and to pray over him. And she did, and that's when he started to get better. But my story is this. We talked about last words this morning, and people's lives are so important. They're very significant as a rule. They know their life on this earth is about gone, and the last things they say sometimes are just very meaningful. But he laid in hospital in a coma for several days. His body had shut down. His wife, Nancy, he says, saved his life because when he met her, she, through love and understanding and treatments, got him out of that world of alcoholism and drugs. But he laid there and the doctors couldn't figure it out. He should have died. The kidneys had failed him. His body had shut down, basically, and they couldn't understand in this coma why he just didn't die. They were just keeping oxygen to him and trying to keep him comfortable. But he laid there for days, and Nancy, his wife, was by his side. And this interested me. All of a sudden, after days of lying there in a coma, she said it almost scared her because it startled her. It startled her. But he raised up his hand and he said, he looked up toward heaven and he said, I'm George Jones. And he said, I've been looking for you. And he died. And she said, I know in my heart of hearts that he saw an angel, he saw God, had come to take him home. And she said, as soon as he said those words, I've been looking for you, his last breath, he was out of here. Isn't that amazing? We just don't know what goes on in that spirit world, so to speak, especially toward the end of our lives. I've often wondered, you know, I had a neighbor who just passed away, that Phyllis Tice had been a neighbor to for about 50 years. Sweet woman. 85 years old, but she laid there for days, and but you know there's a reason. And kids and grandkids coming in and out, and her husband said, I don't know why, she just lays there. I said, there's a reason for it all, amen? But Jerry wrote this song, and he's changed it. We ain't never played it. The chords he's got now, we're just going to follow you, Jerry. I ain't going to mess you up.
Okay.
If you just get in there and you want to say something about that song?
Not really. I wrote Thursday night. During the day, Thursday night. And then finished it up Thursday night. And then I finished it again today.
That's all right. That's all right. Charlie got excited. There's a line there. Said, I've got a good wife. And Charlie liked that, didn't she? That's true.
I got a good life for what? side and give it all. Just to cover my sins, he's the first. And he's the end.
Your voice makes me feel rich when I don't.
that, I don't think. That's good, Jerry. I like that better.
Like that version?
Yeah, I like that version better.
We got one more drive.
Let's stay with it. Yeah, yeah, let's stay with it. All right. Gage, you got something ready, buddy? Get up here. Make a hand. Come up here. Get in there and use mine. There's a big wheel. He's a whole lot bigger than me, all right? Mm-hmm. look right into that sea. There's a big wheel. There's a big wheel. He's a whole lot bigger than you. There's a big wheel. There's a big wheel. He's a whole lot bigger than me. When you think you've got the world by the tail and you don't have to worry about a thing. When you think you don't have to hold on no more, just remember to call out his name. There's a big wheel.
There's a big wheel.
There's a big wheel. He's a whole lot bigger than you. There's a big wheel. There's a big wheel. He's a whole lot bigger than you.
Praise the Lord, I
smiling.